Connected to the same issue of feelings, it is reported in Sunan Abi Dawood, Sunan al-Tirmidhi, Sunan al-Nasa'i, Sunan ibn Majah, Hadith of Abi Jabira. He says that there was a time when the people, or the Ansar, the people had more than one name. You know, they were called by different names. So I know you as Abdullah, for example, but then perhaps some people might know you as Fatty. Fatty, because you're fat. So what happens is, they used to call each other with the name that was detested. And they used to use names that people don't like, you know? Darky, Fatty, whatever else it is. These are nicknames. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed verses prohibiting that. When it comes to a nickname, it is totally forbidden to use a nickname to refer to someone that that person does not like. If they like it, no problem. You know, mashallah, you can call them cutie pie or whatever else it is by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If they like it, there is no problem. Sometimes it might even be, obviously, between the right people. Here we're talking of a spouse by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or a child. If you're using a beautiful name that they love and they would like you to call them by, it can become an act of worship. Because, for example, if that is your spouse, it's the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to use a loving term. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to call Aisha radiallahu anha with the term Humaira. Humaira, referring to the pink cheeks that she used to develop, the blushing that she had. You know, for example, someone would call a person who blushes a lot, referring to their rosy cheeks, as a person perhaps who is maybe rosy cheeks. So if they like that name and if it is good, yes, there is nothing wrong with it. But the minute we use derogatory terms, listen to what Allah says. Verse number 11 of Surah Al-Hujurat.
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٌ مِّن قَوْمٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُونُوا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ وَلَا نِسَاءٌ مِّن نِسَاءٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ.
Allah says, O you who believe, do not mock at one another, lest some are better than others. And even women, they should not mock at one another, lest some are better than others. And Allah continues to say,
وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ.
Do not insult yourselves. How would you insult yourself? By insulting others. You insult someone. There is a hadith which says, one of the worst people is he who insults his own parents. So the Prophet ﷺ was asked, how can a person insult his own parents? So he said, do you see a man insulting the parents of another? So that one then insults his parents. He's the one who asked for it. So by me insulting the mother or the father of someone else, I am asking them to insult my mother and father. I'd rather abstain from it and I don't want to do it. So don't insult yourselves.
وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ.
And do not call each other with offensive nicknames. Never use an offensive nickname to refer to another person, no matter who they are. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our shortcomings and make us more conscious of this. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to use the best of names to refer to people. In fact, it is also good to use the full name to refer to someone. If someone's name, for example, and I'm giving you an example of a long name, say for example it is Abdul Aziz, to call them something shorter than that would actually not be ideal. You should call them the proper full name. And if you want to use a nickname that they love or they don't mind, then it's okay. If not, call them with their full name. Don't, you know, chop the name up, because sometimes it has the name of Allah in it and you've just deleted it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us.